You're listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show, helping you transform your deepest fears into your greatest strengths. Here's your host, Keith Blakemore-Noble.
Hey, hello. Hello. Welcome back. If you're a returning listener, if you're a new listener or viewer, great to have you here. Either way, a very warm welcome to you, as today we're talking all about comfort zones. We're going to explore what they are. We're going to explore what's beyond the comfort zone. I'm going to take a look at some of the less than helpful stuff that's talked about comfort zones. You know, like people who say, oh, I live my whole life outside of my comfort zone. We're going to look at why that's nearly always nonsense. They're not living outside their comfort zone. Spoiler. And we're also going to look at why it's actually damaging to live your entire life outside of the comfort zone. So we're going to look at what they are, how we can move beyond our comfort zone. We're going to look at what is beyond the comfort zone. There's two zones beyond there. We're going to look at those and a whole lot more. Hopefully you're going to find this interesting. The concept of the comfort zone became big in the early 1990s, and certainly in the personal development field and in many other areas, business management, etc., have all used the concept of the comfort zone. But it's not that new. Comfort zones actually come from work that was done way back in 1907. So it's been around for over 100 years. It's been around for quite some time. So what is the comfort zone? Well, as its name suggests, it's where we feel comfortable. Now, stress, anxiety, not so much stress, but anxiety, we need a little bit of it in order to move us along to do things. We need a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of discomfort to sort of drive us to do whatever it is that we're doing. But a comfort zone is where that anxiety is sufficiently low that it's not causing us problems. It's not making us stressed. It's not overloading us. Things are comfortable. Hence the name comfort zone. And many people spend much of their day inside their comfort zone. That is absolutely fine, as we'll see later on. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. But the comfort zone is one of three psychological states. We've got the comfort zone, which is like kind of like the core central bit. We've got our comfort zone. What is beyond the comfort zone? What happens if we increase those levels of anxiety, increase the pressure? What happens? Well, we go beyond our comfort zone and we actually enter what's known as the optimal performance zone. Because they've discovered way back in 1907, and this has been replicated many, many times, we discovered as you increase the pressure, increase the anxiety, increase all of this, we actually become more productive. We become more driven to achieve whatever it is we're looking to achieve. Usually the thing we're looking to achieve is to get rid of that anxiety, right? And so when it rises up, we tend to get more productive. It pushes us out of this comfort zone where we're not doing much. It pushes us beyond that into our zone of optimal performance. But that only works up to a point. If we continue to increase the anxiety, we stop being more productive. We actually get stressed. We go into overload. We enter what's known as the danger zone. Danger, danger. We enter the danger zone. That's where we get overloaded. We get stressed, burned out. We can't concentrate. We make mistakes. Not a place you want to be. So the comfort zone sits right at the root core of that, where things are comfortable. So we're going to take a look at all of this in a bit more detail. But first, before we dive into a little bit more detail, just want to say thanks to this episode's sponsor. It's sponsored by another podcast, Newton's Nuggets. It's run by Paul Newton. You may have come across him before. He's been a guest on a couple of our previous episodes. He's also a brilliant magician, and he runs Mental Theft. Check those out as well. But it's run, Newton's Nuggets is run by Paul Newton and Jesse Lawrence. And it's a great little podcast. Newton's Nuggets delves into different aspects of the life of a modern business owner, providing bite-sized nuggets of advice, information, and the stories behind the people who are experiencing the journey to success. I love the podcast. I've been a guest on it a couple of times. I love many of the guests that they have on there. It's a great little podcast. If you like this podcast, you're really going to like
Newton's Nuggets.
Check it out, newtonsnuggets.com, or you'll find it on iTunes, Spotify, all the best places. Check out Newton's Nuggets, but not before you've listened to the rest of this episode. Now, where were we? Oh, yes, comfort zones, where we're nice and comfortable. And that's comfort zone is usually our daily life as we go about our daily habits, activities. Usually those are things inside our comfort zone. Now, it has been said, all the good stuff is outside of the comfort zone, which is not true. It's not true. There are plenty of things inside our comfort zone which we enjoy, because they're comfortable. I mean, suppose you enjoy curling up with a good book. As I record this, November, it's the weather started to turn. It's getting a bit chilly up here in the Northern Hemisphere. So there are times when you can't beat sitting in with a nice steaming hot mug of tea and a good book, curled up in your favourite chair, having a good read, just escaping the world and going off into a world of your own. Or it might be watching a TV programme or a film, or it might be watching a favourite sports event. Whatever it is, these things are comfortable. They're within our comfort zone. Doesn't mean they're not good stuff, right? We can absolutely enjoy them. There is nothing wrong with that. There is nothing wrong with being in your comfort zone. We can relax, we can rest, we can recharge. We can do that very easily in our comfort zone. And let's face it, we all need to relax, we all need to rest, we all need to recharge if we're going to avoid burnout. So all of these things we can find in the comfort zone. So what do they mean when they say all the good stuff is beyond the comfort zone? Well, again, it's not all the good stuff, but that's where growth happens. When we're in our comfort zone, we're not going to grow. We're not going to grow and develop. We're going to stay where we are. We're going to stay static. Sometimes that's okay. Sometimes you do need a bit of growth. Because if you just stay static for the rest of your life, well, is that making good use? Is that making best use of your life? Is that you living your best life? For some people, it is. For some people, that's all they want. And certainly, perhaps when you get older, when you've done all the adventures and all the crazy stuff, and you're heading towards your twilight years, perhaps you do want to just remain comfortable and enjoy your last few years. Although, again, some people in their twilight years, they want to go really outside of their comfort zone and experience loads of new stuff. Whatever works for you is absolutely fine. And that's a key thing in everything. There is no one size fits all. It's whatever is right for you. Whatever works for you. And that is just as true with comfort zones as with everything else. Eleanor Roosevelt did say, do one thing every day that scares you. Do one thing each day that scares you. And there is a lot to be said for that. Because, see, here's what happens. When we get a bit scared, when we increase that anxiety, we go into our zone of optimal performance, we start doing things that are a little bit uncomfortable, a bit beyond our comfort zone. That's where we start to grow and develop. We learn new things, we develop new skills, new behaviours. I mean, if you're learning something new, it can be scary to start with. But when you keep at it, you get better at it. Your skill improves, your knowledge improves, your ability improves, you get better at it. And it no longer scares you. It's almost a universal law. Whenever you give an analogy, it has to be about cars and driving, right? So, hey, We're going for an analogy. Let's go up with the inevitable car analogy. When you first start learning to drive, chances are, if you're like most people, it's a bit scary, it's a bit daunting. But the more you do it, the more you practice, the easier it becomes, until it's all embedded, it becomes second nature. It becomes, and we've talked about explored the term before, you become unconsciously competent. In other words, you can do it without thinking because it's embedded in your unconscious. You can do it almost on autopilot. So you drive, you've got all the clutch, the brake, the accelerator, the gear levers, the steering, the whole lot. You can do it without even having to think about it. It's no longer scary. And that's how we grow, that's how we develop, by going outside of our comfort zone, by doing things which do scare us a little bit. It increases our anxiety a bit, and that actually puts us into this optimal performance zone where we get really good at learning whatever it is we need to learn in order to cope with and deal with whatever's going on. Which is why when they talk about you should go outside your comfort zone, yeah, that is a good thing. That's how we grow, it's how we develop. However, you do have to be careful not to go too far outside of your comfort zone. Shoot straight through the optimal performance zone and into the danger zone, where it is so dangerous. You're so scared. You have so much fear, so much anxiety. You can no longer function properly. You can't think straight. You can't focus. You can't concentrate. Your manual dexterity starts to go out the window. You kind of get overloaded. That's not a good place to be. That's a dangerous place, and you will not learn. Well, that's not necessarily true, but you're very unlikely to learn, and certainly not going to learn in a good way or a wholesome way. And it can cause all manner of problems. So when we go beyond our comfort zone, absolutely we should go beyond our comfort zone, but do it in smaller steps. Don't leap. Don't go straight from not having a clue how to drive to I'm going to learn how to drive this 40 ton HGV down the busy motorway. Never driven before in my life. Teach me how to do this right now. Let's get on the motorway and drive. That is just whoa. No. But take it in steps. So if there's something that you kind of think you might like to do, but it's just too scary, break it down into smaller steps. What are some intermediate things you can do instead? How can you build yourself up to that? Because, see, here's the thing with comfort zones. As you start doing stuff outside of the comfort zone, your comfort zone expands. Just like with learning how to drive a car, it reaches a point, driving a car initially was probably way outside your comfort zone. After you've had lessons, after you've had practice, after you continue driving, it's now inside the comfort zone. So it's no longer something that's, whoa, don't know how to do this. You just jump in the car and head off and go about your journey. It is now nicely within your comfort zone. Our comfort zone expands. The more we do things outside of it, the more it will expand so that those things now up within our comfort zone. And that's really cool, because it means if there is something that you find a bit daunting, a bit scary, you can learn it, you can master it, you can do it, and it then becomes inside your comfort zone. That's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool thing. For example, speaking on stage, I've spoken on stages around the world. I've spoken to audiences small and large. I think the largest one so far was about 800 people. When I first started, was first learning professional public speaking, I was terrified. Even if we were just in groups, in front of a group of like six people, I was like, oh, it really was scary. I do remember one particular incident in a training course. We were in groups of five. So you stand up in front of the rest of your group for delivery a talk for 30 minutes as we're practicing and developing more and more of the skills. And the trainer went from group to group to group. He'd sit in on a different group in each 30-minute section. And it was my turn to speak in front of our group. I got up. Of course, what happens? Our trainer picks that moment to sit in our group. So here I am, already feeling nervous, already a bit, already quite scared. And now the trainer's in front, trainer's there as well. So, oh my God. And sure enough, as I had started with my talk, sure enough, at one point my mind just went totally blank. Completely blank. And I was just stood there, frozen to the spot for hours. Felt like hours, it was only a few seconds. But I was so frozen to the spot, I just couldn't think. Couldn't think straight, like, oh my God, what am I? Ah! And it genuinely took all my effort to not just go, I'm sorry, I can't do this, and just walk out and leave the course. It passed. That feeling passed. I managed to get myself back on track. Managed to do the talk. But it was such a terrifying, scary thing. Now, however, if you said to me, hey, Keith, I want you to do this talk in front of 1,000 people. You're talking on, I don't know, the mask we wear or fears or hypnosis, whatever it is. You're going up there, you're doing a talk for half an hour, 1,000 people. Okay, yeah, let's do this. And I am comfortable enough to be able to go out there and to deliver a talk and give them great value and serve the audience and feel comfortable in doing it and actually enjoy being out there on stage. What's happened? My comfort zone has expanded. Speaking in front of people has gone from being something outside of the comfort zone to something very firmly inside it. Even something like doing these podcasts and so on. The first few, if you were to check the first few episodes of the very first lot of podcasts that I ever did, oh boy, no comparison. I was really nervous doing those. But the more you do them, the more they fit inside your comfort zone. It's the same with everything that we do. Beware, however, there is a misconception about comfort zones. They say once your comfort zone expands, it will never shrink back again, which is not true. That's not true. Yes, as we do things, our comfort zone does expand so that things which were outside it are now inside it. But it is possible for that comfort zone to shrink again. It's possible for that thing to move outside the comfort zone again. For example, if you don't do that thing for months or years, and then you go to do it for the first time in a very long time, sometimes it can be scary. It is now not within your comfort zone anymore. It has gone back outside the comfort zone. So it is possible for our comfort zone to shrink. So when people say, once you do something, your comfort zone expands, it will never contract again, they absolutely can contract. Your comfort zone is a dynamic thing. However, it's much easier for it to expand than it is to contract. It takes a lot for it to contract. It may feel like it takes a lot for it to expand, but it takes a whole lot more for it to contract. So generally, once you've done something, it stays within your comfort zone. But even if your comfort zone were to shrink because you didn't do the thing for a long time, and the first time you do it, it's scary as anything, that's all right. Your comfort zone will pretty quickly snap back to incorporate it again because you've already done it before. So it's much easier to get comfortable about doing it again. So even if you've not done something for a long time and it's now suddenly scary again, it's not going to take as long for that to become comfortable as it did the first time round. Lovely things, comfort zones. What happens if you live outside your comfort zone? Ooh, because, I mean, in the field of personal development, comfort zones, so many personal development gurus out there kind of teach us that comfort zone is our enemy. Living inside the comfort zone is horrendous. You should never live inside your comfort zone. That's a complete waste of life. Always live outside your comfort zone. I always live outside my comfort zone. Every waking moment I'm outside of my comfort zone. They're talking nonsense. They are talking utter nonsense. Yes, it is important to leave our comfort zones. That's how we grow, that's how we develop, that's how we experience a lot, so much more in life. If we regularly pop out of our comfort zone and expand our comfort zone and experience new things, our life grows, we grow, we get so many more experiences, we have a much, much richer life. So yes, it is important to leave our comfort zone. But it shouldn't become an obsession. You can't live outside your comfort zone all the time. It is necessary, beneficial, essential to pop back into our comfort zone at times, to return to that space where we feel it's safe. We feel safe, we can process what's been going on, we can make sense of it all, and we can relax and we can recover. It's important to do that. And people who claim, I always live outside my comfort zone, they're talking nonsense. What happens is they're doing things which scare them, and their comfort zone expands. So that thing is no longer scary. So even if they were doing something which used to be scary, it is now inside their comfort zone. So they're not living outside their comfort zone at all. They're living inside it. They've done the thing that's scary, the thing that other people think is scary. It's comfortable to them. So they're not constantly living outside their comfort zone. And here's the other thing. They are actually comfortable with being scared. They're comfortable with the higher levels of anxiety. They feel comfortable doing scary new things. Are you getting it yet? For them, doing scary things is the very definition of living inside their comfort zone. It's the very definition. They are really comfortable at doing these new experiences, at doing things which are scary. That's the comfort zone. So next time you hear someone boasting, oh, I live all my life outside my comfort zone, you can be very sure they are living their life firmly inside their comfort zone. It's just that they're really comfortable with being uncomfortable. A great way to stress them out is to get them to go, okay, well, how about you spend a week just not chasing adrenaline? How about you spend a week just really quietly inside reading, pottering around or whatever, and watch the colour drain from their face? As that is now something that's outside their comfort zone. They find it very discomforting. They also find it uncomfortable to be outside the comfort zone. They are living inside their comfort zone. But what would happen if we did forget the comfort zone completely and made sure we always lived life on the edge, beyond the edge, pushing the boundaries, so we're completely outside any possibility of a comfort zone constantly? We risk falling into what's called hedonic adaption, related to hedonism, hedonistic, all that sort of thing. Hedonic adaption. And what happens here is it means that new things, new experiences, no longer impress us. They no longer make us feel alive, because we become accustomed to that adrenaline rush. And so doing these new things no longer gives us that life-affirming experience. In fact, it becomes really dull. We get bored so quickly. It's like the junkie chasing an ever greater fix in order to get that high. First high when you use an illicit substance, the first high, apparently, whoa, really euphoric. But the more you do it, the more your body becomes tolerant of it, the less that high is. The more you need to abuse your body to get back to those highs, you never get back to them again because you've been doing it so often that even taking ever greater quantities of drugs, you still don't get the big highs anymore. And it's the same with people who, if they were to live constantly outside the comfort zone, life would become very dull, very boring, because there would just be no new experiences. They get accustomed to the adrenaline rush. The extraordinary becomes ordinary incredibly quickly. Which is another reason why it's a good thing to be on good terms with our comfort zone. To regularly visit our comfort zone. Yes, by all means, go out. Go beyond your comfort zone as far as you dare, as far as you can safely go. And always come back to your comfort zone. It's a great place to relax, to decompress, to process what you've gone through when you were outside your comfort zone, to process it all, to make sense of it all, to absorb and integrate it all, so that your comfort zone then expands and you can do even greater things with life. There's absolutely nothing wrong with living significant parts of your life, if you wish, within your comfort zone. I shared Eleanor Roosevelt's quote earlier, do one thing each day that scares you. It's one thing each day, not spend your entire day being scared constantly. Just do one thing each day. And I think that is pretty good advice. I think that's a pretty good way to live life. Just find one thing that you do each day that's a little bit scary. It makes you go, ooh, I feel a bit about this, but come on, let's do it. Because the more you do these things, the more it's going to gradually expand your comfort zone. So that a whole lot more things become possible for you. Just something to think about there. I would love to know what you think. I'd love to know your thoughts on this. Please do subscribe. Subscribe to this wherever you're catching. Subscribe to it. Pop a comment. Leave a comment. Let's get a debate going. Share your views. Share your thoughts on this. Give it a like. It would be great if you gave us a rating. If you're catching this on like Audible or Amazon or Apple Podcasts or wherever, give it a rating. Give it a review. Share it with your friends. And let's spread all of this stuff far and wide. I certainly hope you've liked this. I certainly hope you've enjoyed this and found some useful content. Check through the archives. Check the other episodes of the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show. And you might also want to check out 5-Minute Meditation. That's my other podcast. Every Monday, 5 minutes just to meditate. Ideal whether you're an absolute beginner or a seasoned professional. And if you fancy some bonus content and you want to support this, you want to support the channel, the show, check out Patreon. Check out my Patreon. You get bonus content there. Or if you really want to go for it, hey, get in touch. See about sponsoring the episodes. Either way, however you found it, thank you so much for joining me. I will catch you again in the next one. And until the next time we meet, take care, look after yourself. And remember, change is always possible. And when you change your mind, you change your life. Thank you. And goodbye.
You've been listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show, helping you transform your deepest fears into your greatest strengths. To find out more, please visit keithblakemorenoble.com.